Jim?
Reporters' mistakes and disinformation campaign by a foreign government. Does he see a distinction there?
I haven't spoken with him about that, but certainly we would take any misinformation like that very seriously. But it's not something we're comparing the two on. Jim?
And I would just say, Sarah, that journalists make honest mistakes, and that doesn't make them fake news. But the question that
but
I
when
have,
journalists make honest mistakes, they should own up to them. Sometimes, and a lot of times you don't. But there's a difference. There's a very big. I'm sorry. I'm not finished.
Okay.
There's a very big difference between making honest mistakes and purposefully misleading the American people, something that happens regularly. You can't say, I'm not done. You cannot say, you cannot say that it's an honest mistake when you're purposely putting out information that you know to be false, or when you're taking information that hasn't been validated, that hasn't been offered any credibility, and that has been continually denied by a number of people, including people with direct knowledge of an instance. This is something that I'm speaking about the number of reports that have taken place over the last couple of weeks. I'm simply stating that there should be a certain level of responsibility in that process.
That was really something. That's just, it was incredibly rude because he kept interrupting her. But more than that, I mean, at what point do we just simply acknowledge that Acosta is not actually interested in hearing anything Sarah Huckabee Sanders has to say and just bloviating as much anti-Trump statements as he possibly can on live national television?
And I don't understand why he's drawing such attention to himself as a CNN White House correspondent who, with a network, just botched a huge story on the Mueller investigation the Friday before this happened on Monday, the exchange between Sarah and Jim Acosta. Why would you want to draw the type of attention to yourself when everyone knows, and even your own network came out and apologized for their false reporting? Everyone knows that. That's what Sarah's pointing to. So why would you want to do that to
yourself?
That's
the thing. He doesn't care. And it's because nobody who is in power, and none of his other compatriots in the media elite will go after him for what he's done. They're going to pat him on the back for standing up to power, standing up to the White House.
He created this whole situation for himself.